Hey everybody, welcome back to Starcraft 2. I'm going to show you quickly what I have for assembly panel and what is good. I think Death Recall is a really good option here. I would definitely suggest that for this mission, as well as Robotic Assault Annihilator. The ones that basically shoot air if you have a, if you use the Shadow Cannon. I suggest those two. Those are pretty important for this mission. And if you don't have that, you should be in the doing the other mission probably, but if not, you're probably gonna have to readapt your strategy around that. So when I say other mission, you should do Core Hall, I'm saying, because Core Hall gives you the immortals. I just have them right now and I found them to be particularly useful for this mission, so I will be using them. I'm using Orbital Assimilator, Solar Lance, and just deploy pylon 1 point into construction time, and that's it. That's all of my points allocated. So let's head to the bridge.
My Dark Templar have volunteered to act as scouts for us. They will keep us aware of Amon's movements. This was not an easy decision, but I would rather see Shakuris destroyed than overwhelmed by Amon Zerg. We have much to plan, Hierarch.
I just want to mention, 1.8 billion Zerg is pretty difficult, so, well, I mean, we'll see. I mean, it doesn't sound actually that bad, but we'll see it once we begin it. Maybe it's not so bad. I mean, you could just do this on normal. It's really easy on normal.
Tell me, Vorazun, how will we bring destruction to your world?
The Zelnaga Temple's phase prism can be overloaded, forcing a spike of energy into the planet's core. Enough of a charge, and the planet will shatter. Amon will not possess my world.
I have been thinking about this choice.
Are you reconsidering?
No. My time here has reminded me of the courage of your people. That we must fight. If we are to suffer, then so too will Amon. We will lure as many of Amon's hybrid and Zerg through the gateway as we can. Only once enough are through to wound him, will we overload the temple and flee.
You mean to bleed him? Bold, but we can't risk the forces it would require to do such a thing.
Leave that to me, Matriarch. I have learned much from the Dark Templar.
Forces have secured the Zelnaga Temple grounds. Artemis, how go your preparations?
I am configuring the temple now, but without the Uraj and the Callus, it will take time.
Time is not all it will take. The temple's energies are regulated by 3 zenith stones. Only once they are destroyed can the temple be overloaded.
Until then, we must defend it from the Zerg and their hybrid masters.
The Narazim have long used Kaedaran monoliths to protect our lands. I see your face, Smith, has become familiar with them.
Indeed, Matriarch. The monoliths are quite deadly and fire a considerable distance. They should prove instrumental in our defense.
The moment has come. Let us begin.
All right, start with a couple probes and assimilator right away because we have free gas just coming from space.
The Zenith Stones are destroyed, the better off we shall be. The Zerg will overwhelm the temple grounds shortly.
Agreed. Although, should it become necessary, my Dark Templar can sneak through the enemy and destroy the stones.
I mean, to be honest, it's the easiest just to do it with the Dark Templar right away, which is why we're just gonna make the shrine right now. That's kind of how I do it. So, at each Zenith Stone, there is one Overseer. At every single one. I use the Solar Lance to get rid of them. However, this is a big however. If you do that, they will bring one back shortly. So you can't just destroy all, snipe all 3 of these and just go like, hey, you know, it's done, I don't have to deal with it. They will actually rebuild it slowly.
The Zerg gathered for an attack to the southwest. Ignite your blades, warriors.
I also need to start making my next Nexus. We have a nice, easy expansion right here. It's amazing. So we're actually going to work on the Nexus first. We don't actually have to really build any more units at the moment. Because what we have is more than enough. There we go. Apparently they're doing another attack here. Who would have thought? We can go make our Nexus now. We want to just get that underway, and then we're going to just make the gas. We're not building any more defenses for the moment. We're just kind of, we're doing like a heavy economic start, essentially. To be honest, if they cut, they will come from the sides eventually, and you do not have to worry. I'm just letting you know that now. The reason you don't have to worry is because you can just kite them into your defenses right here. Ta-da. Alright, let's just make sure that guy keeps going. I'm gonna hockey these two. Alright, let's start getting the Dark Templar out here.
Another brood of Zerg is preparing to attack from a hive to the northwest.
Alright, I'll show you what the kiting technique is like. Very simple stuff, actually. Oh, by the way, we're making four gateways and about four robotic space. This is a run with primarily doing, so here we go. Watch them get kited. There you go, they're kited. Even though we're not really looking at it. Alright. So here we're gonna start with killing these guys.
Exercise caution when attacking a zenith stone. The energies within may become volatile as it is damaged.
And you're wondering why I'm killing these things? It's because I'm actually trying to take out all the mutalisks too. So now that this has no defense, we just gotta go in for it right now. And we're done. We're good. Oh, and we now have this guy. And that's the heavy economic start. Oh yeah, we need to make a pylon here. We need to make pylons at our entrances because we're eventually going to make that into additional. And that one's done. We have an ultralisk this time. Oh, he might bring that down, actually. Oh, no, we still got it. Alright, now is the time we may be considering to go and make some additional cannons and stuff. But we'll go ahead and do that right now. So we're just gonna make, like,
Artanis, our observers are reporting a vast number of Zerg have poured onto Shakuris.
And yet, not a single hybrid. Amon is testing our resolve.
So you see how they brought like another overseer here? It's really weird, but we can actually use some of this to our advantage. We can kind of take out some of the forces that they usually muster around here, so I'm looking at it every corner. See, this one, they brought another overseer like automatically, so I'll just like take him out again. There you go. Hello. And we're gonna snipe the Zenith Stones. And we're doing it actually fairly early, believe it or not. Usually you don't do that until much later, but I just gotta get them over with, and then I just focus on defenses, so... when you leave these guys here, the Zenithstone also sometimes attacks these guys rather than your Dark Templar, when it starts getting, like, annoyed. Here's some more Dark Templar. We're not making these forever, trust me. Very soon we're gonna switch off. And for this last one, we can... Actually, there's no Overseer here, so... So we can just kind of go snipe him now. And that's the last one. That's all we have to do. So now we just focus on making defenses all over the place. So generally, the strategy I like to go... I like to make a little bit of leeway for us to kind of make... I should just center it around the pylon. You know what we can do to handle that? Just use the laser beams. That's it for that. And the last one has guys right here. So, I did that just because we were building stuff here.
It is done. The Zenith Stones have been destroyed. Once your task is complete, the temple can be overloaded.
Understood. And the temple alignment is proceeding well. Now, we wait for the Zerg.
I think we need some more probes, though. Yeah, I would definitely say we need more probes, all going over here. I kind of stopped producing them for a little while. We're going to work on the Immortals very soon. I don't know how soon, though. I mean, we have a bunch of gateways over here. Maybe we'll make them over here. We just kind of need... Space is actually, ironically, something we lack of. So we just kind of muster our forces wherever they're kind of required at this moment in time. And this forge is seriously in the way. That's not going to get annoying fast. I'm gonna move this guy like right over here, and we'll kill it. Oh, here we go. We have forces here. Now they do happen to have an overseer. Now, if you want, you can use the lasers, and I guess we'll just use the lasers. It's so easy, just using all that stuff. And that way, we don't have to lose all that much as well. I mean, it's just 50 energy. We're not deploying pylons at all. We're using it for strictly just that, and we need way more resources. I usually do something like this, don't I? I'll do like this time. Just to be special. Okay, it's not gonna be perfectly symmetrical, but whatever, I don't care. Oh, we have another one right here. Let's just send all my guys over. I mean, to be honest, is it really necessary anymore? We're just getting wrecked. I mean, this one's not getting wrecked because I lacked in defenses slightly, but the other one was. Isn't that ultimately all that matters? Alright, let's send this guy to fix his defense up. So, I usually just make like a couple of cannons at the front. I find that the Kadurin monoliths are actually just fucking amazing.
Curious. There are overlords closing on the temple grounds.
I have seen this tactic before. They are transporting ground forces. Destroy the overlords, quickly!
Oh, we need more pylons apparently. We can make another one here. Now, if you want, you can actually destroy all the overlords all in one go with your fucking beams. But we won't really bother with that. And what a tactic, guys. I mean, as I said, really not an issue here. Alright, let's go make our robotics facilities. If I do it like this, we're not going to be able to walk past, but yeah, that's fine. I'll walk past through the mineral line.
Our readouts indicate there are nearly half a billion Zerg on Shakurs. All of them moving for this temple.
Let them come. The Templar will endure.
State thy bidding.
Now, this one has a couple guys.
For the reckoning.
Let me just tell him to snipe that. Don't worry, the Dark Templar don't actually die. It's like Zeratul. I bet Zeratul wishes he had that upgrade right about now. I mean, we have a bunch of gateways, but I mean, this is primarily a Immortal strategy just because we like fun. So let's go kill off that guy. And we have some more here, piling up. Ah, here we go, here's our Immortals. I'm gonna put that to hotkey 2. By the way, if you haven't been figuring out the hotkey system I've been using is just like I put my production buildings on a certain value and I kind of bring them over. You gotta use the hotkeys because it lets you focus on like action rather than having to meddle with all your things, you know? Like you gotta meddle with your keys and it's just like, ugh. So don't even bother with it. Save yourself some time. Learn some hotkeys. Okay, now we're gonna make... We're gonna make some additional pylons in some very opportunistic areas.
Be on guard, warriors. The Zerg are attacking the temple from all three sides at once.
I'm not even gonna pay attention to this. Because it's not necessary. It's just like it's easy shit. So we're just building we both need supply and some other crap, so. Banlings might be an issue. I mean, as I said, if you really want to, a great strategy would be to just, like, to use your beams and just kind of beam every single thing at once. But, you know, it does. It's not, as I said, it's not really a big deal. As you see, as you can see so far from me. Whoops, I don't mean to do that. We need way more of these. And we're just bringing them to the front here. This is the main place I find that a lot of, spoiler alert, hybrids come from. Of course there's going to be hybrids. Like, give me a fucking break. It has a defense mission like this, and you honestly thought there was no hybrids to break the lines. Well, fucking sorry. There are. There's going to be shit tons of hybrid. Could be a hybrid zoo. Can we get out of here? Oh yeah, we can. Sweet. So we put basically Kadarians just all the way in the back, and we can put some over here. Because these things have like a shit ton of range. And we can put like one more over here probably. Maybe another one over here. Kadarians are like the shit, by the way. But they are easily disabled by hybrid, so... taking that into account, they're still the shit.
We must defend the temple.
You guys ready? Bam. I don't even think he saw like a glimmer of my forces before he fucking dead. Oh, what the hell? That's not fair. No, stop fucking teasing them. This is why we have the other things, by the way. The Kadarians for. There we go. You know, I could have just used them to shoot up there, but whatever. Where are these guys? Oh, now you go over here or something. I don't know. I don't know what to do with this force anymore. Oh yeah, we gotta keep making Kadarians. That's the name of the game right now, is Kadarians. So, we just make a shit ton of them. And we have more Kadarians backing up more Kadarians. Oh no, you're stuck there now. Okay, maybe what we'll do is we'll put a nice thing for each of these. Oh, actually, this one doesn't need it. Okay, I may have just changed my mind. I don't need to do that. Let's just go through here. Oh, we actually can't. That's why. Yeah, I guess some of my shit died here. Alright, we're gonna bring our forces over here now. And remake a bunch of this stuff. So, because you have such a wonderful economy with two bases and everything... I mean, it's just amazing. Like, you just fucking go ham and basically just make shit tons of units.
Born witness to so many Zerg. Was this the threat my mother once faced?
No, Matriarch. This threat is a far greater one, and it will take all we have to resist it.
You guys go back. Ah, they're just killing this one lone Kadarian. Yeah, fuck these guys. Is there like somewhere over here, like stacking up somewhere? I should probably look at the map before I even do anything. I mean, there's these two, but like, are they really a threat? Fuck this, I don't need to use it. We're at max energy too. And I'm like, no. Yeah, let's remake this one real quick. Just make a shit ton of Kadarians. Let's just have fun with it, you know? Alright, we'll make some more Kadarians over here. Just have fun with it. Some of these guys. Oh. There's a guy. The air cannons are actually like the best thing ever for these guys. At least for this mission, because there's air hybrid, right? But it does require... the downside is it requires you to micromanage it. Oh, looks like... oh, we are totally maxed in supply now. Okay. So, how much will I hold out for? I guess we'll see. You can kind of tell I'm probably in it for the long haul. It's kind of my intent. I love that ability so much. It has such a low cooldown, too. And they're toast. Honestly, I need more up here than anything. Get him up here. I fucking hate the positioning of this guy. Can we get past it? Yes, we can. I hate that, because I wouldn't be able to slip past that then. Oh, we can make some more cadarens over here. Maybe like maybe two is a nice number for these things. There we go. He's getting sniped. Oh, look, some more over there. I mean, I didn't even use the air shoot ability. What the hell is this guy doing?
The moment approaches, warriors. The temple is realigning. It will be ready soon.
Hierarch, I have discovered a solarite cache beneath the Zelnaga temple. If we can hold longer, I should be able to retrieve it.
Begin the retrieval process, Karelix. We will hold the temple as long as we can.
And that's your... And now that the sight goes away for everything, so you can't actually see where things are coming from anymore. Which is kind of a big disadvantage. But all you have to do is you got to keep your eyes out now. I mean, you can pause the game kind of with your F2, honestly, and you can then take a look around. But that's like kind of cheating. But when I say F2, I mean my special ability. Okay, this is actually going to be Baneling, so we're going to actually put a line down each one of these. There we go. Okay, that's gonna be unfortunate. Oh, whatever. Now, some of the hybrids do kind of cancel out some of the air. They cancel out some of these buildings. Unfortunately, it looks like we just lost a monolith there. We'll just take out this guy. We don't really need to be chronoing this shit, do we? I have not optimally done this. Alright, let's have another look around. I mean, there's some hybrids over here. That is pretty much as fun as it looks. Where's our Probus not doing anything? Here he is. Let's kind of make a couple of replacement buildings. We can make some Kadarens right here. I love Kadarens so much. You would not think that these guys would, like, be very good against this, but yeah. But they're fucking amazing against it. So, as I said, they primarily seem to come from up here. They come from a little bit from everywhere, but the main place is upstairs.
The temple thrums with energy. It is ready.
Solarite retrieval is still in progress. If we can hold on just a while longer.
There we go. See, they disable the buildings. That's kind of the only... That's the only problem you will ever have in this mission. So... It's fun to just make the same... Spam the same building everywhere. That could be an issue. Actually, no, it's not. Oh, look, we actually ran out of gas. So, don't press the button yet. We're waiting for 1.5 billion Zerg. We're gonna actually send a couple this way. And maybe over here. I mean, I don't... Oh, there's a shit ton of hybrid here now, actually. We're gonna send, actually, all the dark... We have, like, a lot of, like... really nice ranged buildings for taking them out, you know? A lot of these things. Okay, we need to remake some Kadarens up here. Why would you disable that? What a fucking prick. Okay, it looks like that is the one that's going down right now. That's the one I don't like that's kind of starting to die. Alright, there's some attacks coming up each direction. So, this one's fine. We're just gonna send one beam. We have so much of this fucking power, by the way. Which is why I'm all for that. Let's see. Where's the probe that's doing this shit? These immortals are just like the best thing ever. That's why I like them so much. Let's fucking make a bunch of cannons here. This is the one I actually really have to pay attention to, I think, the most. I always found that to be the really problematic one. Alright. We have another energy thing right here, and oh look, there's banelings here to use it on. Is for some reason this shit on cooldown? Oh, there's some over here. I think we need some more over here. And probably some cannons too. Sound is starting to lag slightly. This is honestly the best one because there's so much space on the sides that like these things don't even make it down the middle, to be honest. Canarians just excel at this. It's like they were made for this shit. Look at this. This is like Death Valley right here, man. Oops, I did not mean to activate that. My game is actually lagging right now. I fucking pick this thing up. That's what I mean, like, every time I have to look at there. Okay, this is a good opportunity to use this thing. It's the banelings which are actually the things that destroy the buildings the most. Some pretty fucking crazy strats. You know, I remember the time I used to do DT walls and things like that. This is a bit different from that.
Successfully warped aboard the Spear of Adun.
Alright, this is the big one. So if we hold out for 1.8, we get an achievement. Right now, we are actually just completely done, by the way. Oh, come on. Waiting for the energy. Ah, here we go. Holy fuck, it's lagging. I like the overview here. It tells a story here. So, I don't know, we'll just kind of remake a bunch of Kadarans, I guess. We're actually running out of gas. It's weird how that became my, the thing I'm running out of. Yeah, there's a couple of things here. Alright, let's, shoot at these guys. Alright, we may not be able to hold out for that. Or we might be able to. Yeah, I think this may be too much for me. Look at all this shit. Fucking ridiculous. Well, there's still a lot of Kadarans for them to go through, so I don't know. I'm debating if I should even be using this. I should, actually. And we're gonna put one more through here. Let's make stalkers. We're gonna just make these guys over here. How many fucking assholes they have, jeez. So eventually, yes, they will break through, and there's nothing you can do. But you'll have fun doing it. As I said, I always found this one to be the problem child. It looks like we're going to be able to hold it, actually. To be honest, I don't think I can get through fast enough. I'm just kind of waiting for... I'm just making distraction units. Remember, we're just 1.8, we get a nice achievement, so... Yay, we did it! Alright, we'll just double-build it. Fucking easiest game of my life.
Templar, initiate dimensional recall. Get to safety, now!
Nice works. The Zerg are poised to breach the temple.
Have faith, Matriarch. Your fallen people cry out for vengeance, and they shall have it.
said that those of our kind suffer. Separated from the glory of the Kala.
You know, Zeratul's not dead. He's fucking narrating, so I don't know what you guys are thinking. How is he narrating? No, he's narrating from the collar or something. I don't know what the fuck. Yeah, so that's that mission. We did pretty good there. I even got this one. I never did this one before, but I'm like, I'll give it a try. And guess what? We did it. So, I mean, this mission is a bit of a recycled from the last mission of Brood War for the Protoss, as well as it's recycled again for the co-op. And they've done a bunch of similar defense related things. So, and do you think this is the last time we're gonna have to defend something in the campaign with cannons and monoliths and shit? I don't know. I wouldn't put my bets on that. Anyways, let's continue then. I should mention though, it is still a fun mission. It is recycled though, it's nothing new. It was just fun kind of doing it with the monoliths, I will say. That was the enjoyable part about it. But yeah, no, it's they've done it several times now.
Shakuris is gone. It has become one with the eternal night. But the traditions we forged there will remain with us forever.
Is that still possible, Matriarch?
More so than you may realize. What do you know of the Shadow Walk, Artanis?
Little. Your people closely guard their customs.
It is our most sacred rite of passage. The initiate stands alone. Members of her tribe strike against her from the shadows. If she endures, she becomes a Shadow Hunter. True Dark Templar.
Why do you speak of this?
You stood alone, as Dark Templar, against countless enemies, risking your life for the many. You have walked as we have. You have walked the Shadow Path already, Artanis. You no longer have the Kala. You are Dark Templar.
The Narazim fought valiantly beside us, even unto the destruction of their world. Why?
Their homeworld has always been Ire. They have never forgotten it, or the sacrifice that delivered them to safety.
You speak of Adun. So saith Judicator Xenthion. Adun failed to eradicate the rogue tribes, those who call themselves the Dark Templar. We witnessed the burst of the Twilight Star. In that treasonous instant, Adun ushered the heretics and himself to fate, purifying Ire of their taint. But allowing them life.
Treason? Adun chose mercy rather than committing genocide. This was a noble act, Preserver.
Was it? I see history through the eyes of those who lived it, Artanis.
Perhaps this is why you are blind to all that is before you. History's truths are only ever understood looking through the backwards lens, seeing its consequences take root.
As a Preserver, I have always experienced history as a living, breathing now, as those who experienced it in the moment did. Perhaps I should consider the way you view it.
But don't give up that easily. Alright, we have no new units, so assembly panel is a useless piece of crap to us. And Karrix doesn't want to talk to us.
At least the Narazim are safe now.
Oh, whatever.
I hope we will be able to rescue our...
Peace out. Alright, we only got 10 Solarite from that, unfortunately. This means we cannot go to anything else. I would still say Orbital Simulator Solar Alliance is the best. These are my favorites, so we'll just put it all into construction time and that's it, so...
In Aradine, Shakuris.
We have warp travel, so might as well use that.
Shakuris has fallen, and Amon's grip tightens. If we are to stand against him, we will need more than warriors. As Hierarch, I was made aware of a location where our Kalai scientists experimented on new weaponry in secret. Within the Glacius facility, the purifier program has been reborn. We must recover this immensely powerful technology.
I mean, this is the only option of where we have to go, so might as well do it.
Glacius facility. Within lies the greatest weaponry the Empire ever developed.
It is the site of the Purifier Revival Program.
Purifiers? The forbidden weapon? They were sealed away by the Conclave, never to be restored.
The ancient purifiers are not kept here, Preserver. They are still locked away. Here, on Glacius, our researchers have been developing prototype weaponry inspired by that ancient technology.
You speak above your caste, Kalai. This is unimaginable heresy.
We are outmatched by Amon's forces and facing annihilation. If this technology may help us, we will use it.
Facility.
Amon has unleashed his servants. Ready our warriors!
The War Council awaits you, Hierarch. The Tal'Darim? They have not been seen since the Aeon of Strife, before the Protoss were united by the Kala's Light.
I'm afraid they returned some time ago, Rohanna. We thought them fanatical servants of the Zelnaga for years, but in truth, they had enslaved themselves to Amon.
Why would any being willingly follow Amon?
That is unclear. The Tal'Darim call themselves the Chosen. What Amon has chosen them for, we do not know. They are dangerous foes who have helped forge the hybrid and shed blood in the name of our great enemy.
Protoss turned upon Protoss. The De'ul demands retribution for such offense. They must be destroyed.
If it is their fate, it shall be.
The purifier weaponry that has been researched here could prove to be a valuable addition to our arsenal.
That is what I am hoping. Is there any merit to Rohanna's fears?
The Kalai on Glacius have prototyped the technology with successful results. It is said that these experimentations are no different than the Templar they are replications of, a byproduct of quantum predictive analytics.
They were and are still only machines. Do not give them such credence, Karrax.
We too are machines of a biological nature. I often marvel at the architecture, the design, the careful construction of our form, our machinery. The Zelnaga forged us as we forged the original purifiers.
Our scouts are reporting Amon's forces are conquering system after system. We must choose our plan of attack carefully, Hierarch.
Well guys, that's it for today. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.